Hi guys, I am so excited to talk about a really cool topic today. I'm gonna keep it short and sweet, and I'm doing this because I got a lot of podcasts, a lot of conferences, virtual conferences lately, and this is a question that is coming up a lot. So, you know, we're always asked, how do you do it? How do you have such a good reputation in the industry? Give us the tips, the scoop. And it really, it comes down to a few really basic things. And I'm gonna, you know, just walk you through them really quick. So, you know, the question always is, how do you keep a good reputation? How do you build a brand that people know about and love? And most times this comes down to how you are, how you treat your business, but most importantly, how you treat the partners and, you know, all the affiliates and all the product owners that you work with. Number one thing is to always be very, very kind and fair. And why this is an important one. Let's say you're a product owner, something is wrong with your domain. You want to offer May goods to your affiliates before anyone even noticed there was an issue. So you might lose a few thousand dollars that day, but in the long run, everyone is gonna know you're the type of product owner that they can rely on. You're the type of product owner that's not gonna shave sales, that is gonna be fair, and it's someone they wanna work with, right? If you're an affiliate, don't request a lot of pay bombs if you're not sure you can increase the traffic, right? Because the network, the product owners, you're doing a favor. They're looking at the average order value, trying to pay you as much as possible, but they do have to take into the consideration how much volume you're going to bring them. So being kind and being fair goes hand in hand here. And if you're serious about your business and building a brand that's going to last, this is a huge one. There's no way around it. And it's super important for you to be kind and fair and just be considerate of the other persons, of your business partners, financial stability goals, but also so what is fair to them in the long run as well, right? So that's a huge big one. Number two is to always be present. I cannot overly emphasize how important it is for you to show up. If you schedule a call, don't cancel last minute. I know it's tough to keep those 10 hours of meetings every day, maybe more, but you need to be, you know, accountable. If you schedule a meeting and you don't show up, that sends such a bad message out there. So one of the really big things is to be reliable, to keep the meetings and, you know, do a good job about rescheduling ahead of time if you cannot. Be present if someone needs something. Don't take forever to reply to an email. The worst thing that I've seen in our industry is following up on an email that I sent a week ago and getting a reply like, oh my gosh, you know, I forgot. That's not okay, right? If you need more help, if you need more people, you know, change your business model, but it's absolutely unacceptable to not get back to people in a timely manner. Again, this is if you're serious about your business and you want the type of reputation that everyone envies. So besides being kind and fair, being present, accountable and reliable, especially with your time, the third one, and you know, the milestone of who we are and a lot of our partners are, positivity. You know, don't be, as long as I start a communication with a new partner, it's so important to see how they treat other partners, right? If they're gonna start telling us bad things about other networks, it's probably not a good fit, right? We appreciate it. We're glad we're doing really well. But it's, you know, there's healthy competition. We don't wanna hear negative things about our competitors. We don't wanna be involved with people that tend to gossip and spread negativity. And honestly, this is the truth for all the big brands that we work with. So positivity is a huge one. Do not build your empire by being mean and rude to your co-managers, thinking that you're gonna get a higher payout if you're insistent and rude. And you know, it's not the time to bring up the people that ask for the manager right away, but you know what I mean, be kind and spread positivity, and that's gonna increasingly come back to you and bless your business in a huge way. So yeah, that's about it. If you're serious about your business, if you're asking me, Anna, what do you guys do to build your reputation and, you know, do what you do to have people love and respect the Maxwell brand, it's easy. It comes down to these three things, and is being kind and fair when you deal with all your partners, affiliates, and product owners alike. Be present and reliable, reply fast and prompt, make sure you're knowledgeable and there for your partners. And three, positivity. Be a oasis of positivity, because that's the type of people, you know, we want to work with, the big brands want to work with, and it's a huge one. So I hope this is helpful. Please ping us anytime you need something. We love you. Have an awesome day, and thank you for working with us. We're, even to the day, we're just humbled by all the success, and we really love you.